Hello, dear students. Today we will be talking about sign conventions for spherical mirrors. Let me first clear that what is sign convention. As you know, the conventions are not actually the rules, or they are not set of formulas, but they are simply conventions, or we can say they are assumptions. And the sign means whether it is plus or minus. Okay. So here in spherical mirrors, we also use sign conventions. That means we use plus or minus in measuring the distances of whether it will be object distance, whether it is image distance, whether it is the distance from focus to pole, whether it is a distance from center of curvature to pole. We use plus or minus in case of concave or in case of convex mirror. So here, let me give an example from mathematical point of view. You are familiar with the number line system, okay? If this is a line, number line, and on the number line we choose an origin, okay? Let this be origin, okay? This is zero. Let zero be the origin, and you know from to the right of this this number line we have numbers 1, we have 2, 3, we have 4, and so on, okay? But these numbers are positive. As you see, they are positive numbers, okay? These are on the right side of the number line. If we turn to the left side of the number line, for example, this is here it's minus 1, it's minus 2, it's minus 3, it's minus 4, and so on. This is the left side of the number line. So on the left side of the number line, we have negative numbers. So we actually choose here the origin, and from that origin, we mark the numbers as positive or negative. These are, we can say, these are the coordinates, okay? Let me give another example. If this is my coordinate system, you will be familiar about this coordinate system. And here we have positive numbers. If we move here, we have positive numbers, okay? If we move on the left side, we have negative numbers, okay? If we move here upwards, we have positive numbers here, and if we move downwards, we have negative numbers here. This is the Cartesian coordinate system, okay? So in the similar fashion, in the similar manner, we have these sign conventions in case of spherical mirrors. For example, this is my spherical mirror. It's a concave mirror, and from here we should be clear that what is the distance of image or what is the distance of object, and we should be clear about that, whether it should be taken as positive or whether it should be taken as negative. So let us discuss these sign conventions. The first convention tells us that all the distances are measured from the pole of spherical mirror. This is the pole, spherical mirror, this is focus, and this is center of curvature, as we know. So here, all the distance are measured from pole of spherical mirror. Okay. That means this pole is our origin. Okay. We measure all the distance from pole of spherical mirror. Whether it is object distance, whether it is image distance, whether it is a distance from center to pole or focus to pole, we measure it from pole of the mirror. This is our first convention. The origin in case of spherical mirrors is our pole. Okay. And the second convention is the object is placed on the left side of the mirror. The object is always placed on the left side of the mirror. So this is our concave mirror. It's concave mirror. And here I will quote this. an object is placed here somewhere here on the left side. Okay, this is the left side. This is left side of concave mirror. So object is placed on the left side of concave mirror. Okay, in case of convex mirror, I can show you convex mirror here. In case of convex mirror, if this is our convex mirror, I'm quoting this. This is our center of curvature. This is pole of the mirror. Okay. Okay, and this is focus, and this is center of curvature. Object is placed here. That means object is placed on the left side of the mirror. Okay, this is our second sign convention. This means that, it also means that when the object is placed on the left side of the mirror, the incident ray is considered to travel from left to right. Okay, incident rays will be like this. Incident rays will be like this. This means that incident ray travels from left to right. Okay, in case of concave mirror, we have also rays traveling from left to right. Okay, traveling from left to right. Let's move to the other convention. Other convention says, convention third, distances measured in the direction of incident ray. This is our concave mirror. See? Distances measured in the direction of incident ray are taken as positive. For example, this is our object. This is our incident ray. The distance which are along this ray, which are in the direction of this ray, will be taken as positive. The distance which are along this ray will be taken as positive. For example, the image is formed somewhere here, and that the ray will be in this direction. Okay, ray will be in this direction in case of this, and this this direction will be taken as positive. This direction will be taken as positive. Okay, and in the opposite opposite manner, distances measured in the direction, distance measured in the direction opposite to the that of incident ray. Distances measured in the direction opposite to that of incident ray are taken as negative. In other words, if the image is formed here, the sign is taken as positive behind the mirror. Okay, here it is taken as positive. And if the image is formed somewhere here in front of mirror, the distance is taken as negative. Okay, the distance is taken as negative, as simple as that. Here the distance is taken as positive, and here the distance is taken as negative. The measured height perpendicular to and above the principal axis is taken as positive. Measured height perpendicular to principal axis or above the principal axis is taken as positive. For example, this is our object. It is above the principal axis, okay, and it is perpendicular to the principal axis. This height will be taken as positive. If it is here, above the principal axis or perpendicular to the principal axis, it will also be taken as positive. And in the opposite sense, distances which are perpendicular but in the downward direction, in the downward direction, are taken as negative. Okay, it's not here distance, it is height of the image. This is taken as negative, and this height is taken as positive. Okay, and this height is also taken as positive. If this is perpendicular above the principal axis, this is taken as positive, and this is if it is perpendicular and to the downward of principal axis, it's taken as negative. Okay, so these are our sign conventions. Let's discuss this sign convention in case of concave mirror. If this is our concave mirror, okay, since the object is always placed in front of mirror, as you know, we never put the image here, because this one is not our reflecting surface. Our reflecting surface is this. Okay, so we place always our object here in front of concave mirror. Okay, the sine of object distance is taken as negative, therefore sine of object distance is here taken as negative. Okay, this is taken as negative object distance, because rays are here and after reflection rays are actually in the direction perpendicular in the direction of principal axis, or the distance is measured from left to right. More precisely, here the distance is measured from left to right. Okay, because pole is our origin, and from the pole we measure the distances, and here the distance is measured from left to right. Okay, right to left. Therefore, this distance is taken as negative. If, for example, this distance is 5 centimeter, it will be minus 5 centimeter, because we are measuring it from right to left. Okay, it will be minus 5 centimeter. The second one is, since the center of curvature and focus lie in front of concave mirror, this is our focus and this is our center of curvature, they lie in front of concave mirror, the signs of radius of curvature and focal length are taken as negative, because they lie in front of concave mirror, and the distance is measured from pole of the mirror from right to left, therefore they are taken as negative. This is focal length is also taken as negative, and this radius is also taken as negative, because these distances are measured from right to left. Okay, from right to left. If our focal length is 2 centimeter, that means our focal length is minus 2 centimeter. If the center of curvature of spherical mirror is 5 centimeter, that means radius will be minus 5 centimeter in case of concave mirror. Okay, in case of concave mirror. And the third one is, when the image is formed in front of mirror, the distance of image is taken as negative. When the image is formed in front of mirror, the distance of image is taken as negative. For example, our image is formed here. We measure it from here, so the distance will be negative. Okay, this will be negative. If this is 1 meter, 1 meter, this will be minus 1 meter, because it is taken as negative. If the image is formed in front of concave mirror, that distance will be taken as negative. Okay, and when the image is formed behind the mirror, if suppose here our image is formed, and this distance will be taken as positive. The distance measured from here to here, this will be taken as positive, because this distance is measured in the direction of incident ray, or we can say this distance is measured from left to right. Okay, this is measured from left to right. This means that when the image is formed behind the mirror of concave mirror, this is taken as positive. this is taken as positive distance. Okay, if this distance is suppose 2 centimeters, it will be plus 2 centimeter. Okay, it will be plus 2 centimeter. And the height of the object is taken as positive, height of the object, because our object is always perpendicular and above the principal axis. It is always taken as positive in case of concave mirror. Okay, it's always taken as positive in case of concave mirror. And the height of image is taken as positive in case of an erect image. As you know, we have only one case in case of concave mirror where the image formed is erect, that is here when the image is placed in between pole and F. Our image is formed somewhere here behind the mirror and that is erect, so this height will be taken as positive. Okay, and taken as negative in case of an inverted image. And you know, in all other cases we have an inverted image. We have inverted image. This height will be taken as negative. Okay. So let's discuss now the convex mirror. If this is our convex mirror, it's our convex mirror. This is principal axis. Okay. Its focus here. This is center of curvature, it's pole here. Okay. Since the object is always placed in front of mirror, the sign of objective distance is taken as negative. Okay. Object distance is taken as negative because we measure the distance from pole from right to left. Therefore, it's taken as negative. Okay. Or in other words, we made the distance which is against the incident ray, Okay. And second one is, since the center of curvature and focus lie behind the convex mirror, this is the reflecting surface. And focus and center of curvature lie behind it. Okay, they lie behind the convex mirror. The sign of radius of curvature and focal length are taken as positive. These signs are taken as positive. Okay, this is positive. This is also positive. This length. It's also positive. Because we measure these lengths from left to right, okay, therefore these are taken as positive. In the case of convex mirror, the image is always formed behind the mirror. Okay, image is always formed behind the mirror here. In case if we put object here or here or here somewhere or at infinity, the object is always formed behind the mirror. It's always formed somewhere here behind the mirror. Okay, as you know, when the object is placed at infinity, the image is formed here at focus, and when it is placed anywhere in front of mirror, it's formed between F and P. Okay, it's formed here between F and P. So you can deduce the relation here. The image is always formed behind the mirror, thus the distance of the image is taken as positive. Therefore, image distance is always taken as positive. If image is formed here, it will be taken as positive distance because we measure the distance from here. Okay, this will be taken as positive and object distance will be taken as negative. Okay. And let's discuss about height. The height of the object is taken as positive. Height of the object is always perpendicular and above the principal axis, as you know, above the principal axis. Therefore, it is always taken as positive. it's always taken as positive. And in case of convex mirror, an erect image is always formed. Erect image is always formed. Okay, so in case of erect image, the height of the image is taken as positive. Therefore, height is taken as positive because this is above the principal axis. Okay, thank you.